Geez, then this bloke play the guitar. Wow. Wonderful talent. Here's a poem, actually, originally written by a fellow by the name of Jim Brown. Now, Jim had a show on television. It was one of those getaway type shows, and I used to watch it. And we discovered this song's been in the wind for quite a while, and Deirdre said, when are we going to do this song about the old Anzac on the wall? I said, okay, it's about time we did it. So I put music to it, and I do thank Jim Brown very much for the opportunity to record the song. It's simply called Anzac on the Wall. Loitering in a country town, 'cause I had some time to spare, I walked into an antique shop to see what was there. Bikes and pumps and caro lamps, the old shop had it all. Then I was taken prisoner by the Anzac on the wall. Such an honest open face, a young man in his prime. And when I looked at the photograph, his eyes locked onto mine. A face so proud and confident inside a dusty frame. I felt myself drawn to him in a way I can't explain. That Anzac have a name, I asked. The old bloke didn't know. He said those who could have told me had passed on long ago. I asked around, but no one seemed to recognize his face. He's been on that wall for years now and deserves a better place. Long you've been alone. I don't even know your name, but you're welcome in my home. Did you fly to Flanders, or perhaps Gallipoli? I'll never know the answer, but I know you fought for me. Where did they send you, mate, when you answered up the call? Were you killed in action? Did you have a home at all? You must have had a family. Will you be claimed one day? To be honest, mate, I hope not, 'cause I'm proud to have you stay. Sometimes friends will look at you and then they question me. And I tell a small white lie and I claim your family. They say you must be proud of him, and I tell them one and all. That's why you got pride of place, my Anzac on the wall. They say you must be proud of him, and I tell them one and all. That's why you got pride of place, my Anzac on the wall. A wonderful story that Jim Brown wrote.